What's going on, guys? Alex here with TFL Bike. It's a really exciting time of the year because we are just constantly getting new motorcycles. It's like a couple times a week the world gets a new motorcycle, so I'm loving it. But today's really exciting because there's a brand new Ducati Multistrada. This is Ducati's flagship adventure slash touring bike, and it's been completely reworked. It has a new engine, new technology features, and it should be easier on the wallet. Kind of. We'll get to that in a little bit. Let's jump into all the details. Multistrada literally means many roads, and it's a good name for the bike because this bike is very versatile. Ducati says it's a sport bike because of its big, powerful engine. It's a touring bike because of its long service intervals. It's an enduro because of its off-road capabilities, and a good urban bike because of low speed ease and smartphone connectivity and also thermal comfort. I don't know that I'd say it's an enduro bike or a sport bike, but it's definitely a bike that can get you on a lot of different kinds of terrain and take you far distances all in one package. Now, the Multistrada is not brand new. The bike originally came out in 2003. It's been pretty popular since then, selling about 110,000 units. But this new one, Ducati says, is better performing and easier to ride than the previous version. Now, we've known that this new Multistrada is coming for some time now, but we didn't know exactly what it would look like. We did, however, know what the engine was going to be because a couple of weeks ago, Ducati announced their new V4 Gran Turismo engine, which we knew was going to go into the new Multistrada. But now we have all the details on the full bike. Let's take a look at that new engine, though. So this is really big news for Ducati. They're going away from the Multistrada 1260 engine. That was an L-twin that came out of the X Diavel, and they're going to a V4. Now, this new Gran Turismo V4 is based on the V4 out of the Panigale, but it's very different from that engine. Now, Ducatis are known for their Desmo technology, or desmodromic valves. For a while, the valves in Ducatis have been operated by cam-operated rocker arms. Now, in this new Multistrada with the Gran Turismo engine, the valves are operated by traditional valve springs. What's that going to mean for you? Well, it's way easier in terms of service. So let's take a look at the old L-twin out of the X Diavel that was also in the old Multistrada. So that engine used the Desmo valves, and that needed its valves adjusted every 15,000 miles. Now, Ducati says that the new service intervals are really industry leading on this new Gran Turismo engine. Oil changes every 10,000 miles and valve adjustments every 37,300 miles. So for a touring bike like this, you know, where you're gonna be putting lots of miles on the highway, the last thing you wanna worry about is checking your valves while you're out on a long adventure. So really cool to see that they're moving away from the Desmo valves and back to just kind of the traditional spring operated valves, at least in this kind of bike. An adventure bike, I think, makes a lot of sense for that. I get that on the track and in your Panigales and really performance-oriented machines, the Desmo valves are still just kind of that trademark Ducati thing that people are gonna want, but in a bike like this, it really makes sense. As far as some of the specs on this new Gran Turismo V4, 1,158 cc's, it makes 170 horsepower, which is crazy for a bike like that that's gonna go rip around the dirt. That is so much power. That's a 30 horsepower increase over the L-twin out of last year's Multistrada. 92 foot-pounds of torque, that's a 5 foot-pound increase over last year's model. The engine itself weighs 147 pounds. It's a very lightweight and very compact engine, which should make for a pretty good handling bike. And although this new Gran Turismo V4 engine is based on the V4 out of the Panigale, there is another big difference besides the valves, and that is cylinder deactivation. The Panigale, it's a race bike. It doesn't use cylinder deactivation. On the Multistrada, you're gonna be sitting in traffic, and one of the main complaints among Ducati owners is the amount of heat that comes off these bikes. They run really hot, and they're not comfortable to sit on in traffic. So now this new Gran Turismo V4 in the Multistrada will have rear bank cylinder deactivation, so it will deactivate those rear cylinders while you're sitting still and make sure the bike doesn't get too hot and keep that heat away from your legs. Now this new Multistrada has an all new design as well. It's pretty similar looking to the outgoing model, the 1260, but they have pretty much redesigned the whole thing. So a lot of similarities, but all the panels are brand new. Still has that kind of beak nose design up front. Personally, I've never really been a fan of that, but I know a lot of people are, so they'll be excited to see that the design has stayed somewhat similar. And the bike, you know, the general shape is still the same. So you've got this really wide front end with the big gas tank, 5.8-gallon tank on this bike. Then the tail section kind of comes to a point in the back, looks really sporty from the back. So the general shape, general dimensions, pretty much stayed the same, but they did refresh the bodywork to make it a more modern looking bike. The frame is all new. It's derived from MotoGP, monocoque frame. You have a 17-inch wheel in the rear and a 19-inch wheel up front, so pretty standard as far as adventure touring bikes go. You know, you're not gonna get that giant 21-inch knobby up front or a 17-inch wheel up front, somewhere in the middle to take you on all types of terrain. And also the swing arm is brand new. So this has a double-sided swing arm. I know a lot of Ducati diehards really love the single-sided swing arm. Again, makes sense in certain applications, but for this kind of bike, you know, where you're gonna be doing side of the road repairs, maybe, you know, you're 500 miles from your home with all your Ducati service tools and everything, and you need to get that bike on a rear stand or something, get the rear wheel off, whatever you need to do, it's gonna be easier to work on with a double-sided swing arm. So I'm glad to see that they're using that on this kind of adventure touring bike. Now in 2010, the Multistrada was the first bike in the whole world to ship with rider modes. That's become a standard in the industry now, but Ducati was the first to do it on the Multistrada. And this new Multistrada for 2021 has an all new feature as well that again is an industry first, and that is radar technology. Now we've been hearing about this for a couple of weeks because BMW and Ducati have kind of been in the radar battle as to, you know, who's gonna come first to market. BMW beat them with the adaptive cruise control just by a little bit, but this Ducati has something that the BMW doesn't, and that is blind spot monitoring. So it does have radar up front for adaptive cruise control. There's also a sensor in the rear for blind spot monitoring. The controller and the sensors are all Bosch components, so they're really high quality stuff. I'm really excited to try this out, and you know, Ducati kind of set the standard for riding modes in 2010. 10 years later, tons of bikes have rider modes, and I think this might be the same thing. Ducati's kind of first to market with blind spot monitoring, and I think in 10 years we might be seeing it on a ton of bikes. Besides the radar tech, there's a ton of other technology in this bike that's become pretty standard in the Ducati world and just the motorcycle world in general. So this bike does have a 6-axis IMU, which measures, you know, where the bike is positioned, how it's leaning front to back, basically every angle you could possibly imagine. And this controls the cornering ABS, Ducati wheel control, Ducati traction control. It also has a cornering version of the traction control. And then on some of the higher end models, the V4S, it will control the cornering lights as well. There's also vehicle hold control, which makes it easier to restart on a steep hill, and Ducati Skyhook suspension, which uses the IMU for its auto leveling function. Now there's three different models of this new Multistrada V4. There's the standard V4, which is just gonna come in red. Then you have the V4S, which will come in red and aviator gray. With the V4S, you do have the option of alloy or spoked wheels versus on the standard model, you're only gonna get alloy wheels. And on this V4S, there are different packages you can add. So essential, travel, radar, performance, and full. These are just different accessory packages that you can outfit from the factory, not have to add it on all afterwards. You know, it just comes as one kit. And interesting to see that radar is in there. So that means radar is not gonna be standard on the lower end bikes. Will be something you have to add on. And then there's the V4S Sport, which gives you a cooler livery, some better paint, and also a performance package, which gets you an Akrapovic exhaust and a carbon front fender. This is a pretty competitive segment. There's some competition from BMW with the R1250 GS, also the S1000 XR. You can also go over to Triumph and take a look at the Tiger 1200. These are all bikes that the Ducati Multistrada is gonna compete with, and all these bikes that it competes with, just like the Ducati, there's different models available within those models, and you can get, you know, different tire packages, wheel packages, all different kinds of things like that. So lots of competition in the space. Ducati needs to keep the pricing pretty competitive. Last year, the bike started at $18,995. It will be available starting in January 2021, so right around the corner, only a couple months away if you want to take a look at one of these. There you go, guys. There's a full in-depth look at the all-new 2021 Ducati Multistrada V4. Uses the all-new Gran Turismo V4 engine, changes up the classic Ducati valves to more traditional valves. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Really curious to hear what you think of this new adventure bike. Is it too much power for the dirt? I don't know. That's something I would have to play around myself to really get a feel for that. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.